So the testimony, I just like what I learned to myself is it will be worth the waiting. So what happened is in December last year, we had a big fire in the kitchen, and then we had to move out. And then after we moved out, I found that the owner was trying to make us the people who burned the house so we can pay for the house, which is like $6,000-$7,000, which is a lot of money for us. So I decided to take her to the court, and I was like, I had a dream, and God was telling me, you're going to take her to the court, and you're going to reveal me. And I'm like, that doesn't make sense, because first, my English is not that perfect. Mm-hmm. Second, I don't have a lawyer, and I'm by myself. Like, this is the only, like, this is the very time I feel like I'm by myself, my family doesn't speak English, and I have to do something. So I went to the court, and before I went to the court, I was praying that God will fill the place with his presence.
Or did you have a lawyer?
Yeah. I tried to get a lawyer, and then he was taking just a lot of money, and I felt like God was telling me, you're gonna do it. It was hard, but I was praying, and then I went to the court. Then something weird happened. When I was sitting there, the judge, all of a sudden, out of nowhere, she said, did you feel the air? She just said that.
Wow.
And I was like, I think she felt God's presence. Or it just was a confirmation. And people was like, oh, it's just an air conditioner, whatever. And then I stood before her, and she's like, where's your lawyer? I told her, I don't have a lawyer. I'm just going to represent myself. She's like, okay, so what you're going to do is you're going to do open statement. I'm like, how does that look like? And she's like, open statement means like you tell the problem and you say what's wrong and blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, okay. And then I start to do the open statement. And then she's like, now you're going to ask the witnesses. I'm like, ask them what? So I start to, but here's the thing. You know when the power of God just controls you? That just like what you say, it doesn't really match your character. It doesn't really match who you are. Just like something controlling your mouth. And that's what really happened. I was asking the people who was accusing me that I burned the house. I was asking them questions. And I started to ask them till the point that now they don't have an answer. And all of a sudden they start to tell me, hey, it's like we don't understand what you're saying. Your English is so bad because you don't have an answer. And I'm like, if my English is so bad, 1 minute ago you was understanding what I'm saying. Why all of a sudden you don't understand? And then the judge had this big smile on her face. And all of a sudden I'm like, I should be a lawyer.
Sounds that way.
People start laughing like I should
you
be
said
a lawyer.
That?
I said that. And she's like, she started so laughing. And then after we finished, she said that she's going to give me my security deposit, which is $2,500 plus the court money, because you pay for the court $400. She decided to make them pay me that money. And I'm like, what? And then people told my mom, you should be proud of your daughter. And my mom doesn't know what's going on because she doesn't speak English. And then another woman came to my mom and she told her, like, your daughter is so good. And my mom got what is good mean. She said, no, it's not my daughter, it's God. And I'm like, did you just say that? Like, that's so good. And then I went back home, I called jewelry, I called a lot of people. But it just like called jewelry, and the first thing I said, like, hey, God did it. And if he did that, it means that I'm gonna get married, I'm gonna have children. It was just like, I was like, you know this moment when God does something big and you read the Bible, you're like, this story's alive. And
wow.
Even gives you, like, 1 minute ago, this story was so boring. Now, this story just gives you a lot of revelation. And I was like, this is just, like, blowing my mind. And I felt like God was telling me the whole time, it will be worth the waiting. It will be worth the waiting. It will be worth the all the time you didn't have relationships. It will be worth the all the time you made yourself pure just for me. It will be worth the waiting. And I was like, God, it will be worth the waiting. I know that, like, my culture, it's just so funny because my culture is like, you're a woman, you cannot stand in front of people, you can this, this, this. And they're just trying to make this picture for you. and they put the frame. You are inside that picture. Don't ever get out. Hmm. And you read the Bible. You're like, oh, this picture is too small for me. Hmm. Like, you have to blow the picture. So funny. You put God in a box. He blow the box. And you're like, you know? So that's really what happened. But it will be worth the waiting for sure.
That's wow. That's encouraging. Like the way you share stories.
Tell the people that are watching, like, if they're going through something, like, just encourage them that, like, God will truly, like, even if they're going through a court case, I don't know.
Yeah, okay. I really believe that two things helped me in the whole time, like, 11 months I was in that thing. The first thing helped me is just, like, trying to block my ears and not hearing my mom, not hearing my family about who I am, and just trying to define myself from God who is telling me about. And the second is community. Community is just a big thing. Without people, it's just so hard to make it. Without even people holding you accountable. And even like, I sometimes come, like me and Jordan, or me and you, or anyone, just coming to Jordan, I'm like, it's so hard, it's getting harder, what should I do? But I remember Jordan told me it would be worth the no, like every yes, how you said it?
Every no will be worth the yes.
Every no will be worth the yes. And I just feel like even in our life, like even like breaking the rules, I feel like even like breaking the rules gives revelation to people. Like in my job, you cannot talk about God. But once you break the rule and getting the phone call, because I'm in a call center and people call me, I mean, I give calls to people and sometimes they call me and they say like I'm sick or whatever, I'm like, I'm gonna break the rule and I'm gonna pray with you on the phone because that's gonna bring revelation to you. One time it was so funny, one time I prayed with that lady on the phone and I was closing my eyes and I opened my eyes, I found my manager next to me. And she was like, had this big smile, which I didn't expect because she knew that I'm crazy, but she didn't expect that. So she's like, wow, that was so awesome, Madonna. But it just like the smile on her face, like it gives her faith. Like people can do crazy stuff just to bring God to people. And it doesn't matter where, because I'm trying to lay down everything. Like if I'm gonna get fired or if something will happen, who cares? It just, this moment can change that person's life forever. I remember that lady, in the like she was giving me a call and she's talking, like she's still talking about a lot of stuff. And then I talked with her, I'm like, but God will, I'm going to pray for you, blah, blah, blah. She's like, you made my day. I didn't expect that I can get a call, like a call from a call center talking with me about God, you know? And it was just so weird. So that's really what happened. But, yeah.
Wow.
That's awesome. Wow.
Thank you guys for listening. You guys are awesome.